It's been a tough few weeks here on old planet Earth. 1 minute everything's normal, the next, boom! Frickin' monsters all over the place. Nobody knows what started it all, but it became clear in a hurry that folks ain't prepared for stuff like this these days. That ain't much of a surprise to me. My name's Hubert Beasley, and I've been teaching high school history for the past 30 years. And if there's one thing I know, it's that people today can't handle any problems that don't involve kitten videos or putting bacon on things. Which is why it's probably a good thing that I've been working on a little project in my spare time. You ever hear about home brewing? Well, that's what I do, except instead of beer, I make human clones. Yup, right here in my garage. Now, don't worry about where I got my DNA samples from, just know they come from excellent sources. You see, being a history teacher means I know all about times when folks really knew how to fix problems. That's right, the past. And I figure if I can just bring back clones of history's great leaders and heroes, I can give them a second chance to save the world. We're starting here in the mall because, well, it's where they always go in movies, right? Also, I figure we might be able to distract these monsters and give any survivors a chance to escape. So, let's make with the monster killer.
A ferocious beatdown.
Killing the monster with the giant glowing key over its head might be a good idea. Have you ever wanted to run amok with a flaming hula hoop around your waist? If so, you're in luck. There. Wait, are you still alive? Holy crap. You gotta shut that alarm off before every monster in the whole place comes out. By the way, my name's Norman Reardon. I'm all that's left of the security staff here at the mall. I'll try and help you if I can.
Man, back in 76, there was a sweet disco in this mall.
And even monsters love hot disco action, right? I bet this Norman guy could help us get the old club sketchy hopping again.
Not again!
Finally, a chance to answer that ancient question about a one-legged man in a butt-kicking contest.
Have you no respect for the office of president?
This place has been abandoned for years, but turning the power back on should get things up and running again. Do you really think terrible music will distract these monsters?
Not again!
Let's go. Cleopatra, coming at ya. It tastes much better than embalming fluid.
A penny for your thoughts.
So that's where they hid that Securoid drone. Blue robots like him are programmed to help you.
The zombies only made this warehouse slightly more dangerous than it used to be. Coming up on Club Sketchy now, I can hear the awful music already.
Thinking it's time for Lincoln.
This guy took the whole breakdancing thing too literally. Pretty much destroyed Club Sketchy. Guess we'll need to find something else to attract the zombies.
Bring forth upon their backsides a ferocious beatdown.
See if you can find the old arcade. I bet zombies love that place. Oh, their foot-long, double hot nacho dogs are the best.
Hail to the chief, baby. What a lovely elixir. Not again.
Smoke.
Oh, what a lovely elixir. Oh, heavens no. Hands off the hat! Oh, heavens no! Thank you.
Games are distracting some of the zombies. Don't get too close to them. Entertain some of the zombies, but we'll still need to find more distractions. Go find the old magician, the amazing head, and see if he can help.
Let's get it on! How about the...
I just want to say that that's how they've always cleaned the escalators here.
I shall protect the union of your face and my fist at all costs.
Soothes these savage beasts. They'll stop trying to kill you and start dancing.
Round and round she goes.
You're not shoplifting, are you? Regardless, you need to shut off that alarm.
Oh.
Looks like the Amazing Head's latest trick is coming back from the dead.
Heavens no!
Dance, dance, dance!
Hands off the hats!
So much for distracting zombies with magic. I guess you'll just have to go back to killing them all instead.